Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Infinite Skyblocks. This is Scoots 42, and between episodes, I had a little bit of an issue. I was trying to make an exchanger, and I tried making something called a potato exchanger, and it basically blew me up. I don't know how to use that thing. It blew me up pretty good, and I lost all of my armor, including the night vision goggles that I had become accustomed to, so I am in the process of recrafting them. I got a good laugh out of it. I mean, it was it was a pretty good surprise. And I have been working on some other things as well, but I wanted to get these goggles made, and I had to make some cactus, so I had to sift some sand. Let's see, here we go, got my goggles back, so now I should be able to see at night again. There we go. Nice. Okay, so let me take you guys downstairs here. Basically, what I've done is I've got myself a third cobblestone generator, which is basically dumping cobblestone in here. And eventually, once it fills up, once it fills up this chest, it'll start automatically piping it in here. And honestly, I don't know how long this is going to be going on for. So, I mean, that chest may never fill up. And then the stuff in this chest is going into our pulverizer, which rests in this bucket. And the sand gets sucked out into here and turned into dust. And we do also get gravel as a secondary product from pulverizing the cobble, which is pretty cool, mainly because I'm running super low on iron. So I've set that up so I don't have to constantly be breaking stuff down with the hammer. It is still technically a little faster to break it down with the hammer, but that stuff is just kind of running in the background. Let's see, I need to get some more iron cooking up. I should have a little bit in there already, and we may as well go ahead and throw that copper in there as well. And what are you? 10. We'll make you, but we'll go ahead and let you hang out up here for a little bit. So the 10 can hang out up there, the lead can hang out, and the rest of that stuff can hang out up there. Let's go get these ores into the smeltery here, and then we'll try to go over. I think I'm just going to go ahead and make the exchanger that I'm actually familiar with. Oh my gosh, I was not prepared. I like totally blew myself up, and it took all of my armor with it. So one of the things we're going to need to do is we're going to need to get some resonant ender going. And according to JEI, I should be able to get it this way. I can melt it down in the smeltery, and I should be able to get a resonant ender bucket this way. And I think I've got a pretty sneaky way of getting it out of the smeltery. I'm going to need one of these extra buckets up here, though. Let's see, here we go. And I've almost got enough dirt out there. We've almost got our, what is that? The passive mob spawn area. So if I set you there, I'm going to set you there for a minute. And I might go ahead and turn you off for just a minute. And let's let that smelt down. Let's grab our iron out of here already. Let's see, I got a little bit out of there. And I needed some bronze for some things. So I went ahead and made some bronze. And I did go ahead and make a reservoir. And before we get too crazy, I completed some quests. And let's open up our loot chest we got from those. Nothing super fancy. I got my iron gloves back, so that's kind of cool. I definitely am missing my leather jacket. Definitely missing that. Let's see, so I think I can get rid of you. Let's put the rest of this stuff in here. Get these metals put away. And I guess you're just going to have to be an overflow chest. Because we're running kind of short on space up there. Let's put you up there. Did I get another one of those pendants? I did. So let's pop you in there as well. And let's go and check on this resonant ender. So, yes, you've resonated pretty nice. And if I'm right, placing a bucket here in this casting table should give me a bucket full of resonant ender. Cool. All right, so you can go back to doing what you were doing. We did get a little bit more iron. There we go. Definitely going to have to do some sifting because we are running low on the iron. And what am I down to there? One block, so that's 9, 10, 11, 12. I think I've got 12 pieces of iron. I don't even know if that's enough to get this exchanger made. But let's give it a shot. This is the one I tried to make. And I did make it, the tuberous exchanger, but I blew myself up with it. So I'm going to be staying away from that for a little bit. What is this, lead? We need some lead and some copper gears. So we're going to need 16 copper. There we go. And we need a little bit of lead. And so let's get our copper cooking up here. Make sure you're off. Oh, good. We did have... I thought I had more iron in there. It must be in that fluid duct. Must be what's going on. Like I said before, I don't have a whole ton of experience automating the smeltery with thermal expansion or thermal dynamics or whatever thermal that is that we're automating it with. See, I think we've got some seeds to put up if there's room. Where's my seed chest? Here we go. So I did have to plant some cactus to get the cactus green I needed to get my night vision goggles back. I've been playing with them since nearly episode one. It's kind of hard for me to go on without them now, so I went ahead and made some more. A little later, I might automate this cactus farm, and I'm trying to think of a simple, cool way to automate the sugarcane. I do have some ideas about how to do that. Now, let's see if our copper is ready. I'd really like to get this exchanger made, especially since I found out these corp. I don't have any in my inventory. We'll check on that in a minute. There we go. So let's get our... Did I put you in there? I did. I'll show you guys the corp here in a minute. Those corp blocks that we've been getting, I found out how to cycle through those so we can get quite a few different textures. And it looks like I am really getting the energetic sheep out there. I'm kind of hoping that I'll be able to find a way to actually generate power with them. Because they are totally powering up these shears. So that'll be pretty cool. Like I said, I don't know if there's a way to generate power with them, but it seems like there should be. So I might be able to look at their wool. I have a few pieces of their wool that I sheared to begin with to make these. So that's all for those. You can see these are quart blocks, type 12. I've been playing around with them. Let's see. So I need this exchanger tier 1. And that's going to need some kind of red dye. So I think the easiest way to do that is going to be to get some bone meal and hope that we get some flowers from out here. And this is coming right along. I've been harvesting these, and I finally did get those, what do you call them, essence seeds to plant. That wasn't the flower I wanted. I need some red flowers. Do you think we can get, is that too much to ask? Can we get, oh, there's one. And there's two. That should be all we need. I know it said we needed four, but we do have that pulverizer now. So I should be able to temporarily suspend our cobble operation down there long enough to get some dye out of it. Ooh, there's another flower I've never seen. You know, we got all kinds of animals out here now. This is getting kind of crazy out here. But every time I shear one of these guys with these energetic shears, you hopefully can see that bar filling up. Because it's actually getting power from them. So that's pretty cool. I think they're almost nearly charged now. 830 out of a million. And that's like a million RF, I think. Yeah, a million RF. So if I can find a way to power other machines with these things, that would be fantastic. All right, so let's see. We need this thermal expansion core one of this guy. And so we should be able to get that now. Awesome. And it looks like we need a little bit more lead and a basic flux capacitor. Now, sulfur, I don't know if we have any of that. We might have to see how we can get some sulfur, because I don't think we have any. Sulfur comes from netherrack. Soul sandstone has a 40%. Blaze rods has a 50% chance. Soul sandstone, huh? That might be the ticket. We have a little bit of soul sand. Let's see if there's anything we can do to get sulfur. Sulfur cloud. Well, that's not what I want to do at all. Sulfur. I'm kind of surprised we haven't gotten any from some mob drops. See, reflux column. Induction smelter, which we don't have yet. So I'm thinking it looks like our best chance really would be to do that. That'll give us a 40% chance. Oh, the soul sandstone also gives us a 40% chance. So let's get our soul sand here. I'd have gotten a little bit, and we can get a little bit more if we don't get any sulfur. But I should be able to do this and get this stuff. So let's head down to our pulverizer and see if we can't manage to get some stuff here. So let's temporarily disable all those things, and we'll set you like that. Let's go ahead and pull that cobble out of there. You can go back up here for the time being. And let's just see. Let's pop this in there and see if we can't get some what you call it out of there. And while that is waiting, let's be a little sneaky and put these poppies here. And then we can turn you back on input. Cool. So did we? We did. I think that was all we needed. Sweet. And let's see if we got some dye. We did. Nice. So let's get back to crafting our exchanger. Let's see. So we already got our thermal expansion exchanger core tier 1. So we need the flux capacitor, which needs a little bit of lead, piece of copper. I think altogether we needed like 8 pieces of lead. That sounds about right. What else did we need? 3 pieces of redstone and some copper. I think we only needed 1 piece of copper. I don't remember, so we'll just grab 3. Let's see. Leadstone Exchanger needs this guy. Nice. And so we should be able to get an exchanger. Cool. This guy will be cool, but we don't really have a way to power it yet, is the thing. I wonder if there's a way, like, do you cycle through anything? No? Okay, so what we're going to need to make, then, is an energetic infuser, I believe, which is going to be this guy. And we might not have the redstone to do this. We're going to need 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 pieces of redstone. So let's grab a little bit of our dust out of here. And I believe we get redstone, I want to say, from... I think we can get it out of a flint mesh. Yeah. Nice. 12% chance. Okay. So a stack, we should hopefully get the redstone we need. And I always get a kick out of this, because you can see that redstone just go flying. And it, I mean, it flies everywhere. I think we'll need to do another... we'll need to do another round of the dust here. Well, actually, we need to put some of this stuff up. Wow. We got quite a bit of stuff out of that. Let's dump off some other things. I'm putting the solid fuel in there. We've got quite a few bird eggs taking up inventory space. Let's see. Is this the seeds? Yep. So the bluebell can go in there for now, and the dandelion, and that's good for now. So let's grab another stack of dust and see if we can't get a little more redstone action going on. So did any? It did. Look at that. I mean, look at how far away this redstone flies. It's comical how far away it flies. And I don't think that gave us enough. So let's do one more batch. Do one more batch. Because these energy cells are terrific. They really are. But there's no built-in way to charge things. So the way to charge items with, what mod is it, thermal dynamics or thermal expansion, whatever thermal it is, you have to have the energetic infuser. 3, I think that might have given us enough. Oh, yeah. There's a bunch of it hiding on the floor down here. Okay, so we should have enough now, hopefully. Because we needed to make quite a few. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we need to make quite a few of these guys. So we're going to need gold and silver. So you're an electrum. Which we may or may not have. Let's get a little bit of electrum going. And then we'll come back and craft these other things. All right, so let's get that in there, and make sure you're off. We had one more iron ingot in there, okay. We'll get you up there. need some more gold and silver. So while we're waiting on that, let's get these guys crafted. Is that the one that needs electrum? Yeah. Okay, so this one we should be able to craft. That just needs some gold. And then these are going to need silver. One more of those. There we go. And I think we're going to need to get some copper in there as well, because we're going to need some copper gears. Hopefully our electrum is ready, and then we can pop this copper in there. Looks like it. And it looks like we've got blood in there again. These birds keep landing in there. Well, let's see. Well, let's get the electrum out of there first, I guess. We should have a couple ingots of that coming. That bird stuff is still in there. I wouldn't actually mind getting that. Let's do a little something like this. There we go, we got it. And then it's like nothing ever happened. Then we should have our electrum, nice. Turning off, and let's get our copper in there. Oh, not the shears, please. Thank you. Right, so we should be able to get this last little bit here that needed electrum. And we're also going to need some tin. There we go. Hopefully that copper is pretty close to done. These birds are just everywhere, I'm telling you. Yeah, there we go. Let's see. And that tin melts so quick. So quick. I want to make sure we get that copper out of there first. There we go. Now we should be able to pop our tin in. There we go. All right. Let's see here. We need a machine frame, which we're going to need 4 iron for. Machine frame? Yeah, there we go. And now we should be able to get the energetic infuser. Nice. Very nice. So let's go and get this guy plugged in. See, and I think you can just live right here for now. We'll do something a little prettier later on. Let's just, what in the world? Weird. Okay, so we should be able to pop our exchanger in here and let it charge up. There we go. And it is charging. It's a little slow at first until we can get this guy here upgraded. But definitely a case of slow pay is better than no pay. Now, so while he is charging up, let's get some stuff put away. Get all that stuff put up. There we go. And I don't normally like to be wasteful like this, but I'm just kind of curious to see what cooking this raw bird meat is going to do for the food. And it looks like we can eat it now safely. Okay. trying to see if there's any food in here I haven't eaten. Yeah, I think we'll just let it go for now. I do like that. I think it's Spice of Life variation mod. I think it's still Spice of Life that's doing this. Let me see if I can... yeah, I think it's this, the Spice of Life Carrot Edition. I think that's the one that's doing it. Which is pretty cool. But every time we eat a predetermined number of different kinds of food, we basically get... What did I need that for? I could have sworn there was something I needed it for. Every time we eat a different variation of food, it lets us gain a couple of hearts. So it's definitely worth getting into. Could have sworn that we were going to do something with that red dye, and now I don't remember what it was. Very interesting. I mean, was it... I thought we needed it for something in the exchanger. Did we end up having... Could have sworn we needed red dye for something. Maybe I was looking at this. Yeah, that must have been what it was. I must have got it confused with the exchanger core. Because this is needing some kind of red dye. Okay, well, that mystery solved. And at least we have some red dye if we need it. Yes, you can go here. There you go. See if we can't get some of the rest of this stuff put away. And I think, let's take a look in our quest book. I don't think we've gotten any quests done today. Let's see if we can't do something about getting this auto sifter. So let's take a look at that. I don't know how much I'll use this. I can't really guarantee that I'm going to use it a lot. Looks like we're finally going to get to use that stone gear we made forever ago. Do I still have some cobble in there? We've got some slabs. Let's go ahead and turn those back into cobble. And we'll need two more of those. There's one. And there's a total of three. Ooh, and it looks like we actually need four more of those. There we go. There's those. So we need a stone axle, which is going to need stone rods. So let's go and see. Maybe I still have some cobble in here. Not enough. Let's just go grab a stack from out here. I've slowly whittled down the cobble population in with our general stuff over here, so I think I finally was able to wear enough of it out. Okay, so we need this stone axle thing. We need six of those. So 2, 4, 6. And we'll need a couple of hoppers. And so that's going to be 10. 11, 12 pieces of iron. Alrighty. And let's see about getting a couple of pistons. We just need any plank wood. There's one. And two. And we're going to need some hoppers. There are those. And now we actually need our stone axle. And then this should get us the auto sifter. Neat. And that completed our quest, which gets us a stone axle and a water wheel, which is going to be extremely useful, since we need basically a water wheel to power this thing. Let's see. Hopefully this reservoir I made will work like a bucket. So let's see here. I think what we need to do to get this to work is we'll have like the stone axle here, I think. And then, let's see, we need to get out there somehow. So let's kind of come out there, and we'll get rid of this stuff in just a second. Oh, that's right, we did this on the bottom. I don't know exactly how much space this thing is going to need. I'm not sure that that's the way I want that to face. Can I, well, let me spin that around? Not really. So we got it back at least. There we go. Now it's facing the way I wanted it to. So if I, can I switch you to, yeah, there we go. I'm not really sure how this works. Let me try some things here. So can I do that? Okay, so that looks a little kind of derpy. Let's pick you back up. Is that a thing I can do? Is that an option? Use while sneaking to activate. There we go. There we go. Okay. Let's try this on the other side. Something like that. That is just crazy to me. It's somehow purposely spinning on the wrong side, but I guess we'll just deal with that for now. So you go in there like that, if I remember right. And then I think you go on top. Is that how that works? I don't remember exactly. I'm pretty sure that this goes on top of it somehow. Oh, you know, I think we need to spin this around. Is that a thing I can do? So much I don't know about this. Let's try it again here. Well, it looks like it's still trying to go on there the same way. What if I, can I do it like this? Now, is that the way it's supposed to be? I mean, you don't think that's how it's supposed to be. I don't know, keep forgetting about that. I gotta be a little further away. There we go. Let's just grab a mesh and pop it in here. And maybe it needs some kind of a redstone signal? We'll try that real quick. I know we're getting just about out of time for the episode. Let's see, you should have a piece of cobble in here. Let's get a redstone signal to it and see if that does anything. And I'll continue to play with this between episodes if this doesn't work. Because it doesn't really look like that is spinning. So I guess let's try putting it back this way. Yeah, I don't know, guys. I don't know. I will do a little research on this, do a little bit of homework, and try to find out how we're supposed to use this thing. Honestly, I don't know, you know, that I'm going to use it all that often because we're going to have some powered RF things that's going to basically do the same thing with not nearly all of this setup and stuff. So, I kind of want to check it out so that, you guys have a chance to see how it's supposed to work at least. I'm not going to completely give up on it. I at least want to know how it's supposed to work. I think that's been bugging me for a while, and these have been bugging me for a while. Oh, there we go. So I hope you guys enjoyed the episode today. When we come back next time, hopefully I'll be able to go over this real quick and kind of see how we're supposed to hook that up. And we did get our exchanger. It is powered up. So before we go, really quick, I want to take some of this cork and just kind of show you guys really quick. With the corp with a P in your hand, hold down shift and then use your mouse wheel to cycle through this stuff. And there was one I thought I might use. Is it that one or this one, I think. So if we take one of these out and pop this in here, I should be able to use this exchanger. There we go. Nice. Yeah, I think I'm going to like this. And can we use... I don't remember if this basic tiered one can do more than one block at a time. But that white concrete is coming back into my inventory, which is pretty cool. So, we're going to be able to start really shaping this base up, I think. We're going to be able to do a lot of stuff, because a lot of the what I would call placeholders, there we go, I think I like that a lot better. A lot of these, we'll be able to start swapping out our oak wood slabs for something a little more aesthetically pleasing. I think it's just going to be a good time all around. So I hope you guys had a good time today. We did get a little bit done. We got a couple different machines up and running. I'm going to continue working on that passive mob farm area out there behind me. I've almost got it. We've been getting a lot of the dirt coming in from, that stuff right over there. I can't even think of the name of it. Mystical Agriculture. We're going to start getting back into that real soon. We're going to start, crafting some other stuff with it. We'll be getting a lot of resources coming in from that. the mob farm's still doing really good. I think it's going to be time here in the next few episodes. We're going to kind of revamp our whole mob farm idea and start collecting experience from it. Lots more to come, so stay tuned to the Infinite Skyblock series with Scoots 42. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Remember to check out Infinite on their Discord. Thanks for stopping by today, guys, and take care.